Now we turn our attention to the investigation. The FBI has done a great job tracking and identifying the terrorists. We know there were approximately 19 hijackers involved with the four planes, seven of whom were pilots. Some of the hijackers lived in Florida, where reportedly they lived in quiet neighborhoods, but a few of them reportedly inhabited strip clubs and drank heavily. Right now, there is no evidence that any other terrorist actions are in play. However, authorities do believe there are terrorists at large who supported the hijackers. With us now is John Walsh, the host of America's Most Wanted on Fox. Mr. Walsh will have a special two-hour program Saturday night beginning at 8 Eastern time. So everybody in America wants to know, you know, is the threat still here? The FBI's information is, are these people trying to run away now, or do they have other action planned?
Well, certainly the FBI is looking all over the country, as many law enforcement agencies are, the U.S. Marshals, etc. And one thing about bin Laden's cells are that they're so tight and they're so good, they call them sleeper agents. And why they call them sleeper agents are because they meld into society so well. For example, the guy in Vero Beach, little sleepy Vero Beach with the flight safety school down there. He lived down there with his wife and children for about 2 years. His kids went to school. His neighbors thought he was an upstanding individual. And 3 days before he knew he was going to go to Boston and hijack this plane, he said goodbye to his wife and kids, left everything in the house, plates, towels, everything, and sent them back to Saudi Arabia. So they're hard to find. A lot of them are probably trying to get out of the United States right now. Some of them are probably still here figuring, you know what, we're going to wait for our next orders.
Now, at the beginning of the conversation, you said the bin Laden cells. You're 100% convinced Osama bin Laden ran this operation?
I am, and so I believe that most people that are in intelligence business and law enforcement believe that it is bin Laden. He did it in 1993. He tried to blow up the World Trade Towers. He did it in the embassies in Africa. He successfully killed over 200 people there, 19 Americans, and he has professed repeatedly that he hates America and that he's going to send a huge message. And this was his message. I tried to take the World Trade Towers down in 1993. This time I took them down, paralyzed the financial world in the United States, stopped all the airlines, and they're celebrating that right now.
You know, with so many of these guys in the United States, 19 hijackers, I mean, and I was stunned when those four planes took off. I thought that our security measures in the air would prevent this kind of a thing. I was very surprised to feel that you could get through to the crew, that the doors are penetrable. You know, why are they penetrable? Why don't they have impenetrable doors?
Well, you fly as much as I do.
Yeah, I'm all over the place.
First of all, number one, we don't have the security procedures that they have in Europe. If you've ever taken a flight to Israel or if you've ever taken a flight to Germany, your bags are on the jetaway. And if a bag isn't claimed, that bag doesn't get on the plane because you can put explosives in there and then go home and detonate it with a detonator. So in Europe, they've been used to this for years. I did a show with Interpol years ago. I did the World's Most Wanted. And their number one guy was Osama bin Laden. And they showed me in their secret map room thousands of terrorist attacks that had been done by different militant groups throughout the United States. And it was very prophetic. The head of the Interpol at that time said to me, you know, you Americans are so naive. It's coming to you.
Yeah.
You're not prepared for it. You don't have the security precautions. Anybody can get on an airplane. And what did they do? They got an airplane. They used plastic knives. How do they take it over? They get a stewardess or a woman in the front. They slit her throat. Everybody's terrified. They bang on the door. They open the door. They speculate that they killed two of the pilots. They took
well,
it right
why would they open the door? See, that's the
it's
thing.
It's not
that's
that hard.
You and I have gotten
on flights where the door's been open, where they've let children come in there to see what the pilots are like. I mean, I fly all the time. It's not hard to get open a door. Those doors
well,
are
that
thin.
Well, that's got to change. That's got to.
Absolutely.
In your special tomorrow night, are you going to be trying to alert people to who's at large? What kind of people are running around? Is that what you're going to do?
Oh, absolutely. We're devoting 2 hours to what happened here and what happened at the Pentagon. And, you know, we've been very successful. And that's because of the American public. We've caught 682 fugitives in 15 years. We've caught 14 of the FBI's 10 most wanted. We caught 3 weeks ago Eric Rosser, who was an FBI top 10 fugitive, a child molester pedophile, who had plastic surgery, liposuction, and went all the way to Bangkok, Thailand to avoid the FBI. And a woman, a teacher watching our show on the Air Force's satellite network, saw him applying for this school, took his application
in
to the U.S.
Thailand,
Embassy
right?
in Thailand,
yeah,
in Bangkok, and mailed him to Bangkok.
Do you have pictures of people that are suspected
Absolutely.
Of terrorists? Absolutely.
Abdul Rahman Yassin, he's still wanted for planning, one of the major guys who planned the World Trade Center bombing, and they think that he was
so
involved
tomorrow
in
Tomorrow night on Fox Network, you're going to show some pictures of suspected terrorists
Absolutely.
And this and that?
Bin Laden's number
right.
two man. They're all warrants out for these guys for other types of bombings
right.
whatsoever. And they're just skilled at it. And there's a lot of misconceptions, you know. We keep hearing, and I listen to those ministers and the retaliation of Arabs in America. You know, all of that is wrong. There's lots of people in the Arab world that hate Osama
yeah,
bin Laden.
That. All right, John. We'll look for your program tomorrow night, Saturday night on Fox. And thanks for coming in. We appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you.